Just tell the Lord, Lord God, I'm expecting.
That's right.
Yes, Lord.
I'm expecting just what you said. I'm expecting the word that I'm standing
Amen.
On. Lord God, I'm expecting to have blessing. I'm expecting the Lord God to operate in righteousness. I'm expecting to operate in the fruit of the Spirit. I'm expecting growth. I'm expecting, Lord God, prosperity. I'm expecting good health. I'm expecting, I'm expecting, Lord God. In the name of Jesus, that's the power of expectation. I want you to know, and as I said, as I'm closing tonight, that we keep in mind, remember blind Bartimaeus. Hallelujah. Blind Bartimaeus. See, remember blind Bartimaeus. He had no sight, but you know what? He's just Bartimaeus right about now because he's no longer blind.
Yes. Amen.
Blind,
amen.
No one, because he came expecting.
Yes, preach fast.
You know, you were like, well, by faith. But see, faith, yes, he believed.
Amen.
But expecting allowed him to receive.
Yes, Lord.
What about the Seraphician woman? When she came to the Lord and her daughter was demon possessed.
Yes, yes.
Is anybody you know need to be set free from some type of demons in the name
of Lord?
The only thing you have to do is just, you know, you have faith and expect it. You know, at the moment that she prayed, she believed by faith. And she just said, I received that. I'm expecting.
Amen. Amen.
By the time she got home, the Bible says around the same hour.
Yes,
that they said that she was free was about the same hour that she was
Lord.
Free. I'm like, that's what I'm talking about. That's the power of expectation. Yeah. I'm talking about right now. Yes, you
Lord.
Can
now.
Put a demand on an anointing. Yes. You know,
now.
You know why you haven't gotten a demand on an anointing? Because you never put one
now.
On.
Yes.
Come on. Now, Lord.
Now,
Lord. I can share a personal testimony right
Lord.
There because you must understand. There was something that came up. It was a 911 for me.
Amen.
Hallelujah. It was a 911 for me. And when I got the news, I could, you know, I got it on a phone call.
Amen.
Those are there. You know, that's the worst kind.
Yes.
I got it on a phone call. And surely enough, I had to get my composure. I slapped my hand down and I got up and I took off. I took off into my prayer area.
Yes.
I took off. I didn't go. I just took off. Oh, I was storming, but I was. And I said, Lord God. I said, Father, I start quoting those scriptures that I've been quoting day in and day. And I said, Lord, you said.
Yeah. Yes.
You said, Lord God. Yes. You told me that your word shall not return. You said you'll keep all of my children. You protect them all, Father.
Yes.
I start reminding.
Yes,
and I said, Lord God, I know you're going to do it today.
Yes.
I know I need it. I need it done right now, Lord.
Yes, Lord.
I need it done right now,
yes,
Lord.
Yes, Lord.
I need it done right now. I'm here to tell you that too. That restroom was on fire.
Amen. Amen.
It seemed like it was on fire when I came out. It looked like nothing but smoke.
Jesus.
Hallelujah. When I came out,
yes,
I walked
Lord.
Around. I'm here to tell you the people that saw me come in, they were looking like back up because they knew. Oh yeah.
Amen.
Because my mind was set.
Amen.
I was
Amen.
There because I was expecting God
Amen.
To do that. Because while we were in there, I want you to know when you're going to get in this place right here and you decree and declare, Lord, I expect, look,
yes,
when you
Lord.
Turn your face from the Lord, just be
yes,
seeing it.
Lord.
That's
yes,
all I don't
Lord.
Expect nothing else but what God said.
That's
I don't want to hear nothing. Don't come tell me nothing else.
Right.
I don't want to hear.
Right.
I'm expecting what God said and what he's going to do.
Amen.
And I want you to know, lo and behold, and see, for me, it was to hear the voice of that individual.
Amen.
Because see, I hadn't heard it.
Amen.
And I was told all kind of things, but I hadn't
uh-huh.
heard it.
Uh-huh.
And sure, guess what happened? The phone rang. When I picked up that phone, and it seemed like I could have just quivered and dropped it. I want to like, thank you, God. And so I kept my composure. And I said, Lord, I thank you, Father.
Yes, Lord.
Thank
yes.
you, Lord God. And just the sound of that voice made me understand the Lord God said, I heard you.
Uh-huh.
And
yes,
you were
Lord.
Expecting
yes,
for me
Lord.
To move. And
yes.
I put a demand on the
yes,
anointing.
Lord.
I want you to know that God is not, he's not afraid. He's not scared. He's a big God. Nothing's too hard for God.
Amen.
He was like, well, you're not, I'm not testing the Lord. I'm doing what he told me to do.
Amen.
Remind him of his word.
Amen.
Hallelujah.
Amen.
And I put a demand on the anointing
yes, Lord.
Before it would happen right then.
Amen.
I want you to know it was less than 5 minutes, people.
Yes. Amen. Oh, yeah.
Hallelujah.
Yes, amen.
I'm telling you, God,
hallelujah.
Less than 5 minutes.
Hallelujah.
See, I must tell you, it felt like it was an eternity.
Yes, ma'am.
You know, when you don't
yes.
hear the voice that you
yes.
need to hear,
uh-huh.
and you heard that something
uh-huh.
happened,
amen.
And it lasted, it seemed like it's like
yes.
Years.
Mm-hmm.
Yes.
When I look at the time number, 5 minutes after the
time. Amen, amen. Yes, Lord.
Glory to God.
Yes, Lord.
That's how you know, but the
yes,
power
Lord.
Of expectation.
Right.
I shared that
yes,
with
Lord.
You to understand that, yes, you can pray that way.
Yes,
you can expect
yes.
God to move. The power of expectation. Lord, I need it now.
Mm-hmm.
I need
yes.
it right now, Father God. I thank
yes,
you, Lord.
Lord.
I'm standing upon your word. The power. I'm expecting.
Right now,
amen.
My faith sees it. Now I expect it to happen.
Yes, Lord.
Woo-hoo. You know, that's a bold preaching right
yes,
there.
Lord.
That's a bold teaching
yes,
right
Lord.
There. I thank you, Holy Spirit, but as he's ministered,
yes,
he said,
Lord.
How do you think that the woman with the issue of blood received
yes,
her healing?
Yes,
the woman with the issue for 12
yes,
years. I'm closing, but you must understand
yes,
the woman
Lord.
There. 12 years, she spent all the money that she had.
Yes, Amen.
They had doctors back then too.
Preach it, Pastor.
The scripture says she saw every doctor she could see.
Yes, yes,
and she spent all that she had.
Amen.
She lost all of her prosperity, all of her savings, everything she had. She spit it upon the doctor and still was not yet better.
Amen.
Woo! But then she heard that Jesus passed.
Hey!
She might say, you know what? I don't may not have much at all.
Yes,
but I know the Lord's in town. And I'm gonna make it to the house.
Yes,
I'm gonna make it. And you know, I don't care how much they squeeze me out. And you know, even the disciples said, what this woman tried? I'm going to weasel my way through this hill. I'm going to crawl if I got to. I'm not going to let nothing block me. I don't care if I got to push aside some obstacles, push aside certain people, push aside negative family, push aside negative blood, push aside. But I'm going to touch the hem of this garment. That's my point of contact. The power of expectations. I know that when I touch the hem of his garment, the word the Lord got said in Malachi, that is healing in his wings.
Yes, Lord.
I know what the talit represents.
Yes,
the talit represents wings of the Lord. And whenever you get, she knew because she heard a word that was preached.
Woo.
And she believed that God spoke a word to her. And you know what? She said, you know what? What else have I got to lose?
Yes, Lord.
Come on now. You see, some of us, we're not in a place of, well, I ain't got nothing else to lose. Already, when you get that desperate, hallelujah, put that power of expectation. I can't go no more.
Thank you, Lord.
I can't go no more than where I am right now.
Amen.
What else? They're already laughing at me. Yeah. They're already calling me a big joke.
Yeah.
But watch who gonna be laughing.
Yeah.
Hallelujah. My issue gonna be taken care of. My way through the crowd.
I had
the power. I expected. She said, you know, that's in the faith of God. Remember, she had faith. But the moment she touched the hem of his garment, virtue left out of him.
Yes, Lord.
The Lord God felt that virtue had
yes,
left
Lord.
Him. That was a point of contact. That was a power of expectation. She said, the moment she had faith, remember, she saw herself healed.
Mm-hmm.
And then she popped, I'm going to receive it.
Yeah.
She touched the hem.
Just the hem.
That's just one of these corners. That's not even the whole. She didn't even grab them. Just a little bit.
Him.
See, some of us need the power of expectation. If I can just get.
Just a little bit, Lord.
Just a little bit, Lord. Just give me a little crumb.
Give me a little crumb, Lord.
And surely enough, as I close tonight, you must understand, like the woman with the issue, she did get her miracle.
Amen.
You can get your miracle tonight.
Amen.
You can get everything
Lord.
That God said.
Amen.
Everything that I promised you, it is yours. He said, but you got to expect me to. You got to expect to receive it in the name of. You got to expect God to say, you know, I told you that it was yours. I told you that it was already. I told you that you were healed. I told you that you were blessed. I told it to you already. You just got to receive it in the name of Jesus. Oh, yeah. And when you do receive it, hallelujah, you're going to be just like the lame man who got up and started
Jesus.
Walking. He was so excited that he started jumping and leaping. He got in the house. You know what? When power of expectation comes about and you start receiving and the blessings start flowing, people's like, who is that?
Yes. Preach it, Pastor.
Is that that woman that was crying all
Jesus.
The time?
Jesus. Yes, Lord.
That's the one that was getting a ride from here and there.
Yes, Lord.
That's the one.
Amen,
and that's the one that didn't have no food. And that's the one her kids were just. And that's the one. And all of a sudden, all of them saved.
Yes, Lord.
That's the one that ran around the Cadillac. Is that the one?
Yes, Lord.
Yeah, that was the one that didn't have. I was doing Tom and Jerry.
Amen. Amen.
Trying to get a ride.
Amen.
The Lord God said they're going to be in amazement.
Jesus.
In Acts chapter 3, they talk about 10. They said the people were like,
amazing.
They were like, what?
They will be amazing.
Is that the same woman? Is that the same man that was at the gate?
The name of
is that the same one that was broken?
Yes.
I was passing by. He was
Jesus.
He was on my nerves. I was begging me.
Yes.
You remember that was, you know, you're always crying and praying. And you're like, oh, she get up there when they cry. All of a sudden, you're not crying no more.
Hey, Jesus.
That's
Lord.
That's a little bitty girl.
Crying.
Come on.
What's her name?
Before? Jesus.
What's she do? Where that church at?
Lord.
God, I want you to know I'm claiming it. I'm receiving. I'm expecting for peace in the kingdom, miracle crusade. I'm expecting miracles.
Yes, Lord,
in the
name of Jesus.
Father God, we give you glory today.
Yes,
come on,
Lord.
Let's stand up. Let's give God glory. Come on, hallelujah.
Thank you, Lord.
Thank you, Lord God. Thank you, Lord. Thank you, Father. Oh, yeah. Thank you, Lord God. Thank you, Father. Yeah, yeah, yeah. Thank you, Lord God. Oh, yeah, yeah. Just lift up your hands. Lift up your hands. Yeah, yeah, yeah. The power of expectation. I hope you came expecting to receive tonight in the name of Jesus. Father God, thank you, dear Lord, as I seal this word upon your sons and your daughters, your kings and your queens tonight in the name of Jesus. That, Lord God, the power of expectation. Lord God, we're looking forward for you to move. We're expecting for you to do great and mighty things. Lord God, we're expecting miracles, signs and wonders.
Yes, Lord.
Lord God, we thank you in advance.
Thank you, Lord.
For moving on our behalf.
Thank you right now, Lord.
Now, Father God, as I pray and I seal this word upon every individual, the sound of my voice. And we said amen.
Amen. Amen. Amen. Amen. Amen.
Come on,
Lord.